In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 2 free worksheet, Points in 3 Dimensions. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, before we jump into our first section, let me quickly draw the coordinate system. Now, in this case, this is our x-axis, this is our y-axis, and this is our z-axis. So we're going in to 3 dimensions. And the point at which the x, y, and z axis meets is known as that origin. So for this x axis, in the positive x direction, we're going to be moving forward. In the negative x direction, we're going to be moving backward. Now for the y axis, in the positive y direction, that's going to be moving to the right. And in the negative y direction, that's going to be moving to the left. So if we remember our two-dimensional coordinate system, when x and y are both positive, that's going to be quadrant 1. And in this case, it's moving forward and to the right. And then lastly, we have z, which our z-axis, if we're going in the positive z direction, that's going to be going up, and the negative z direction is going to be moving down. So knowing that, let's get started with number 1. In this section, we're going to be describing the location of each point in relation to that origin. So number 1, our x, y, and z values, that's how this coordinate is written, x, y, then z, is 4, 0, and 3. So because this 4 is positive, we're moving 4 forward in that positive x direction, and because this 3 is positive, we're going to be moving 3 up, and we're moving 0 right or left. So quickly again, forward's positive, backward will be negative coordinates, right is positive, left will be negative coordinates, and then up is positive and down will be negative. So our solution in number 1 is 4 forward and 3 up. Let's move on to number 2. In number 2, x, y, and z is 2, negative 3, 3. So because our x is positive, that means we're going 2 forward. Our y is negative, so we're moving 3 to the left. And our 3 for z is positive, so that's going to be up. So that's 3 up. 2 forward, 3 left, and 3 up. Continuing on to number 3. Our x coordinate is negative, our y coordinate is positive, and our z coordinate is positive. So because that x value is negative, as opposed to moving forward, we're going to be moving backward. So that's 1 backward or 1 back. For y, since it's positive, that's going to be 3 units to the right, because moving right represents the positive y. And since z is positive, that's going to be going up, so 4 up. So again, 1 back, 3 right, and 4 up. In number 4, x is negative, y is positive, and z is positive. So we're going to be moving back, right, and up. So 2 units back, 4 units to the right, and 4 units up. In number 5, x, y, and z. X is positive, so we're moving forward, so that's 1 forward. Y is negative, so we're going to be moving to the left, so 3 to the left, and then z is positive, so that's going to be 4 up. Again, that's 1 forward, 3 left, and 4 up. And then lastly in this section, x is 0, y is negative, and z is negative. So because x is 0, we're not moving forward or back, we're just going to be moving right or left, and then up or down. But since y is negative, that's going to be 2 to the left, and also since z is negative, that's going to be 4 down, as opposed to up. So 2 left and 4 down is the location of this point in relation to that origin. Now for numbers 7 through 10, we're given a diagram and we're going to be writing the coordinates of each point. So remember, Moving forward from the origin is in the positive x direction. Moving backwards is in the negative x direction. To the right is in the positive y. To the left is in the negative y. Up is in the positive z. And down is in the negative z direction. So our coordinate is going to have an x, a y, and a z value. First, let's start with x. So we're looking at this x-axis here. So looking at this axis, you can see that we're 1 unit forward. So that's going to be a positive 1 for x. And now we'll take care of our y-coordinate value, where y is this axis. And remember, to the right is positive, to the left is negative, and we're moving from that origin 1 to the left. So moving 1 forward, we're now moving 1 to the left. Therefore, y is going to be negative. So that's going to be a negative 1 for y. And we're not moving off of this xy plane. We're not moving up or down in the z direction. Therefore, z is 0. So our coordinate in number 7 is 1, negative 1, 0. We moved forward 1 and then to the left 1. And 0 up or down. Let's move on to number 8. And number 8, we're looking at this point over here. So let's start with that x-axis. We're moving 1, 2, 3 in that positive x direction. So we're moving 3 forward to be on the same plane where the point lies. So that's going to be 3 for x. Now we need to figure out how many we're going to move either right or left. And that's going to be, if we were to extend out the lines on the y-axis, we're going to be moving 1, 2, 3, 4 to the left to be on that same plane. 4 to the left to get to where it is in the x and y direction now. So that's going to be 3, negative 4. Now you can see we need to move 1, 2, up in the positive z direction. So that's going to be 2 up. So our coordinate in number 8 is 3, negative 4, and 2. So 3, negative 4, 2 is our solution. And again, you can see that z was moving 2 up to be on the same plane. Y, we had to move 1, 2, 3, 4 to the left. And x, we had to move 1, 2, 3 forward. Let's continue on to number 9. And number 9, starting with our x value, we can see that we're not moving forward to get to this point. Instead, we're moving backward. So we're going to be moving 1 back. So x is negative 1. You can also see that for our y value, we're going to be moving 1, 2 to the right. So that's going to be a positive 2 for y. And then lastly, z. From that origin, it's 1, 2 units up to get to that same height. So that's going to be a positive 2 for z. So negative 1, 2, 2 is our solution in number 9. And again, from that origin, we're moving 1 back to get to the same forward or backward distance, 2 to the right to get to the same right or left distance, and then 2 up to get to that same height. And lastly in this video, we're going to be going over number 10, filling in x, y, and z. So let's start again by looking at x. X is the forward or backward direction to get to that point. And you can see that we're going to be moving 2 backwards to get to that point. So 2 in the backward direction to get to where that point lies, so that's a negative 2 for x. Now we're going to look at y. Y is either moving right or left. Moving right is positive y, left is negative y. And in order to get to that point, we're moving 4 to the left. So essentially we're moving 4 to get to the edge of this prism where that point lies. So that's going to be a negative 4 for y. And then lastly, for z, we're moving 1 up to get to the edge or to that face of that rectangular prism where that other point lies. Therefore, we're at positive 1 in the z. Negative 2, negative 4, positive 1 is our coordinate in number 10. So if we were to start at the origin, we would move 2 backward, then 4 to the left, and then 1 up to reach our point. And I'll go ahead and stop this video here. Continue on to the next video where we will plot each point in numbers 11 through 16. Before continuing on, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.